By the end of this video, you should master how to play Hallelujah by Alexandra Burke on the violin without the need for any shit, because we're gonna show you what notes you're going to be playing and how you're gonna be doing them here. But if you know how to read shit, we also have the shit here, and we have slow play along and normal speed play along to guide you to make sure you can read that, right? So that's available in the description. All right, so without too much talking, let's get straight right into it. Welcome back to Toks Violin Academy. I'm Samuel. I'm very, very excited to have you here again. If this is your first time here, I give you tutorials, I give you lessons, I give you the tips you need to take your violin playing from beginner or intermediate to that next level. So if you're interested in that type of content, make sure to hit that subscribe button there. Turn on the notification right beside it so you do not miss when videos like this come up. Right, so you must have heard Hallelujah before, right? Sounds like this. And so on, right? So we're gonna show you what key we're in, because one thing about this channel is that we don't just give you the notes, show you the fingers, we show you how it works musically, the music theory behind it as well, to make sure that you're a well-rounded musician. All right, so let's do that. Right, so in key of D minor, which is a close sister to F major, right? So the easier way to do it, to rate the notes we have here, is to play it as though we're in F major. So we're going to do an F major scale first, show you where notes of the F major scale are. So we have F, G, A, B, flat, C, D, E, F with an apostrophe, showing you that that's the higher F. If we go here, we have E, we have D, notes with comma, show that these are the lower versions of this note. Alright, so let's do an F major scale. So we'll start with F, which is a lower second finger on the D string. That's our F, G, A, B flat, lower first finger at the tip of the A string, C, D, E, lower first finger. So you have a lower first finger at the tip of the E as well as the A. You have a lower second finger on the A as well as the D, which is going to be used to play C and F respectively. So F major scale again with me. Right, so those are the notes we're going to be using in this piece. These are the notes you're going to see, so it's advisable you do that first so you get familiar. So now let's get straight into it. Like you know, we have lyrics right here which is going to guide you, even if all you can do is hum the song, so take advantage of that as well. Like I mentioned before, sheet is available here, it's in the description, so if you know how to read sheet at this level, just go straight to that, use the slow play along first and then the normal speed play along. Alright, but if you're using the notes, then watch this video all the way to the end, because by the end of this you should be able to play the song. So we have A starting. Similar thing again. Next line. Keep going. High F now. Lower first finger on the E. High notes and that's the verse and then the chorus. So like I mentioned, whenever you see notes with apostrophe, for example, if you keep going on that side, you're gonna have G with apostrophe too. Whenever you see notes like that, we're referring to the higher version of this note. This particular song is used mostly at Christmas as well, but it can be played any other time of the year. Apart from that, I have 20 of the most popular songs. I'm talking about Rockabye, Despacito, Stay With Me, popular songs that do not change with time. They're available in the description, 20 of them with notes. Sheet, play along, tutorials like this available there. If you want to build a repertoire, you need to have this song so you could play for weddings and stuff. So after this video, check that out so you do not miss out on those ones as well. All right, let's get back into it. Right, and now we have chorus coming in. Keep going. Similar thing again. Thank you. if I'm going too fast, make sure you're pausing each of the section and practicing with the notes and the lyrics to help you as well. And then you try to do it with me. Let's move on to the second verse. If you've not subscribed yet, this is the best time for you to do that, because content like this, videos like this, tutorials that could take you playing to that next level, music theory, coming for you every week, and you do not want to miss any piece of it. So hit that subscribe button right now, turn on the notification. If you've gained value so far, click the like button, because it's very important, helps YouTube show this video to more persons. Let's get back into it. So second verse we have. You could add that slot at that first part of second line for verse two, like I did right there. So just try to replicate some of these things that I do. It's gonna make it sound really beautiful. We have. That's it for the second verse, and then the chorus, which you've already done, comes back in. So we're gonna skip that, and after that you have an interlude. After that there's a key change going to key of G, right? So let's do a scale of G major quickly. So we have G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, and then higher G, higher A. If we to go this side, we put commas showing that these are the lower versions of those notes, right? So let's do a G major scale fast, because things are going to change. We have G, A, B, C. You see that B is no longer the tip of the string, it's coming up. We have D, E, F sharp, and second finger G. This is a relative major to E minor, which is exactly what this is saying, but we're gonna place we're gonna play the note. They have the same note as though they're in G major, and it's gonna sound the same as well, because it's easier to read. Right, so this is what we have there. We have, keep going. Good, keep it going. High notes. And then chorus comes in. Take your time on it. Then the same thing repeats, right? So that's the whole thing. Like I mentioned, pause each of the sections if you find it too fast. Practice each of the notes with the lyrics. Even all you can do is hum the song. It's very important that you do that, because it's going to help you. Alright, so that's it for this one. If you want to learn vibrato, make sure to stick around, because we're going to talk about stuff like that at some point on this channel as well, and you do not want to miss it. So that's it for this one. Go practice. We have 20 of this song in the description, like I had mentioned to you. Right, so if you want to build your popular repertoire, go in that description right now and make sure you get on it. We have Rockabye, Despacito, and much more for you. So that's it for this one. Do not forget to practice, because even with this note, if you do not do that, nothing is going to change. Right, so go do the work, and I'll see you here in the next one.